You wanna come sit with me?
Mm-hmm.
Wanna sit? Look, can you see yourself? Say hi.
Hi.
Hey. Hey, do you wanna come be in the video?
No.
No? Alright, let's see how long he messes with the camera and maybe he'll get bored of it. No, 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 no. Don't click buttons. Come here. Come here, let's play with the ball.
Hey.
Hi. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I'm going to be filming my week 34, 35, and 36 pregnancy update. He's so confused who I'm talking to. I'm talking to the camera. Yeah. Oh, baby, can you leave it? Can you leave it, please?
Hi.
Hi, you waving? So like I said, we'll see how long it takes him to get used to the camera being set up right here. But I'm filming with him awake because I really want to take my makeup off when he goes to bed and just relax. And he's going to bed in like 20 minutes. Jackson, baby, I have this exercise box. I'm getting ready to pop this baby out. So now he's playing with the exercise ball. You can play with the ball, okay? So like I said, I'm filming my week 34, 35, and 36. I'm actually 39 weeks pregnant right now. I'm really behind on these. Jackson, baby, don't press buttons. Like I said, I'm 39 weeks right now, so I'm really behind on these. But we took like makeshift maternity pictures today. So I have my hair and makeup done and decided that I should probably film a video because I do want to continue to do these pregnancy updates until I have the baby, and I'm 39 weeks today. So I want to be able to like catch up on these really quickly. And I wrote actually in my notes, I wrote weeks 34 and 35. Because they were like the same symptoms for both weeks, so that's why I'm just kind of combining everything. Wanna give a kiss? Oh, it's so nice. Wait, don't drink that. Don't drink. Hey. Can I have that? Don't drink it. Yeah, put it down. Thank you. So anyway, let's just jump into this video so I can get done with this so that I can play with him before he needs to go to bed and before he gets really bored. Give me a kiss. Thank you for breathing right in my mouth. All right, so my first symptom for week 34 and 35, like I said, I had like the same symptoms for those weeks. I said I feel huge and uncomfortable, and I remember that week my stomach literally felt so stretched out and so big that I was just like so uncomfortable, and I like literally felt stretch marks like forming, and I actually have gotten a few more. They're not terrible. They're in the same place actually. I haven't gotten like more stretch marks. They've just gotten like a little bit darker. Like they, like you can tell that they have definitely like worsened, I guess is the word. I don't know. My next symptom is my groins hurt. Even now, my groins hurt so bad. Like in the morning, they feel like they're stuck. Like I have to like literally get up out of bed and stretch in the morning and like move around. Otherwise, my groins literally, like I can't even walk. They like pop when I walk up the stairs. I mean, this isn't even an update for right now, but like at 34 and 35 weeks, they were like just starting to hurt. So imagine like how bad they hurt now. But yeah, my groins hurt really bad that week. The next symptom is so much kicking and moving. And I remember that there was like, it literally was to a point where I was like, oh my God, please just stop moving. Like I wasn't really getting like kicked in the ribs. Like with Jackson, when I was pregnant with him, he kicked me in the ribs all the time, and baby is head down. So I should technically be getting kicked in the ribs, but like this baby just doesn't kick me in the ribs really. She moves like down low, like in my pelvis. It's so uncomfortable. It's so annoying and it's ridiculous. And it got really bad. You're stepping on my phone, baby. It got really, really bad that week. Or not really bad, but like there was just a lot of movement and a lot of kicking that week. The next symptom is I was having contractions at night, and I only had like 3, and they weren't consistent or anything, or they weren't like consistent enough to be worried about it. It was every like 15 minutes. I had 3 like every 15 minutes, and then it went away and I went to sleep, so it wasn't like that big of a deal. But I do know that I had contractions that week, and I've been having them like on and off ever since that week. But that was something that had just started that week, and they were like really bad at night. Like they woke me up at night. It was really uncomfortable, and I remembered that happening. So that's it for my symptoms for week 34 and 35. Moving on to cravings, I wrote down that I wanted gummy candy. You okay? You just being destructive? Okay, but I think it's because it was around Valentine's Day, and I just like had a bunch of candy here, and Max got like a bunch of like gummy candy and stuff like that. So I think that's why I wanted gummy candy. And then I also was watching something. I don't remember what I was watching now, but I remember I was watching something and she was eating gummy worms, and I was like, oh my God, I want that so bad. So yeah, I really wanted gummy candy. And my next craving is cake. And I remember because I actually started watching Cake Boss. What are you doing, Goofy Butt? Can I even kissy? Thank you. I started watching Cake Boss and like DC Cupcakes and all these shows on TLC because I just had nothing to watch, and I just wanted cake. Oh baby, can you just leave it? Can you just
leave it.
Yeah, play with the extremely loud toys while I'm filming a video. That's okay. Anyway, I was saying I was craving cake. I remember texting Max and being like, oh my god, I want like chocolate cake and vanilla frosting. Like, oh my god, I make the best homemade, not homemade, box made chocolate cake and homemade vanilla frosting. Like, it's so freaking good and I wanted that so bad. Like, I was craving that week. Moving on to week 36 before he starts aggravating. Oh my goodness. Can you just leave it? Leave it, please. Stop. No, don't press buttons. Don't press buttons. Play with your horsey, please. You want to play with that? Okay, you can play with that. Wow, now I know why I film videos when he's asleep. So moving on to week 36. My first symptom is groin and hip pain. Like I said, the weeks before that, I guess, were just the start of it because it literally has gotten worse, because then my next symptom about the groin pain for my next pregnancy update is intense groin pain. So it progressively got worse. This week at 36 weeks, my groin and hip pain were super, super, super bad. Wasn't as bad as it is now, but I remember it got worse and worse every week. I don't know why. It was never that bad with Jackson, but it just got worse and worse. And it was bad that week. My next symptom is strong sense of smell. And I remember that I was having like the weirdest smells. Like it was so weird. Like, I would pull into the garage and then come upstairs, and I would like obviously turn my car off in the garage, and like the exhaust, I would smell the exhaust when I'd come upstairs. I'd be like in the kitchen making food, still smell the exhaust. Come sit on the couch, watch TV, still smell the exhaust. Like, I seriously thought I left my car on at one point because like the exhaust smell was so strong. I was just having a crazy sense of smell that week. My next symptom I wrote down, over being pregnant, LOL. I'm so funny. But no, I do remember at 36 weeks, that was the start of me being like, I'm done with this. Not the start of me. That was like my peak of like, okay, I've been done with this for a few weeks now. I'm at an all-time high. I'm done with this. I'm so over being pregnant, and that car is so obnoxious. Why did I turn that on? Baby, can you play with a quieter toy? No, you just want to play with that one? So yes, I remember I was just like done. I'm so done now. I'm so done now. And 3 weeks ago, I was done. So imagine how done I am now. My next symptom, I wrote down contractions again at night. This I also wrote down, 3 at 15 minutes apart. It was really weird that the 2 weeks, like 2 weeks in a row, I was having 3 contractions at 15 minutes apart. And I remember it was at like 3:45 in the morning, 4 and 4:15. And then that was it. And I went back to bed. So it was really weird that it was at like the exact same time those 2 weeks. But that was happening, and it only happened like 1 or 2 nights during the week. It wasn't every single night. It was only like 1 or 2 nights. But I remember I was having contractions, and it was kind of freaking me out because I was like, oh my god, am I gonna have this for the rest of the pregnancy? Because it was only at 36 weeks. So I was like, really, for the next like month I'm gonna have these? And I haven't had them that bad, so thank god they haven't been that bad. But I am 39 weeks today, so it wouldn't surprise me if things started now. But that is it for my symptoms. For my cravings, I wrote down pears, and I remember I wanted Max to like go to the store and get me pears. Oh, you want to sit with me? You want to sit with me? Aww. Oh, you just wanted to walk over me.
Hi.
Hi, you saying hi? You see yourself? Oh. But yeah, I wanted Max to go to the store and get pears because I think I had one when I went home or something, and then I was like, oh my god, these are so good. And we went to the store and got them, and he got like 5 pears, and I ate them all week. So they were so good though. Pears, I don't know why, even now at 39 weeks, I love pears. They're just super freaking good. I also wrote down, I'm done with cravings, but for my weight, I also wrote down my weight. I don't know, I don't really talk about that a lot because I don't know, I'm very self-conscious about it this pregnancy, because with Jackson, I literally gained like the bare minimum, like 18 pounds or something when I was pregnant with him, and this time I'm almost at 40 pounds or something. I don't know, 35 pounds. Like, I don't know, it's just a lot more this pregnancy. But I wrote down that at my doctor's appointment my weight was 172. So my appointment a month before that I was 167, and then a month later I was 172. So I guess it's not too bad, but like for me, I never got, I think I hit like, I topped out at like 160 when I was pregnant with Jackson. I started at like 140, and then I was like 160 when I had him, and now like I'm 172, and I'm like, oh my god, what's going on? So for me, that's just a lot, but like for me, that's a lot, not for everybody, but I don't know, it's just, I'm like just more self-conscious about it this time, I guess. But that is actually it for this pregnancy update. I can't believe I got through that quickly, especially with Jackson being out here with me. But like I said, that was 34, 35, and 36. I think it went more more quickly, more faster. I don't know. What am I saying? It went faster, I think, because 34 and 35 were combined. And then for my next pregnancy update, I combined 37 and 38 because those symptoms were like the same too. But now that I'm done with everything, like I said, I'm 39 weeks right now, so I can't really do a belly shot because this is for 34 and 35, 36. So I don't want to do a belly shot now, which is really annoying that I'm like so behind on them, because I was really loving that I was updated with my videos so that I could do belly shots. So that sucks, I can't. But if I have pictures or anything, I'll insert them right now. I haven't taken a lot of pictures like throughout this pregnancy until just recently, so I don't even know if I have pictures. If I have some, I'll insert them, but like I said, I really don't think I have any, which is so unfortunate. But that's going to be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Jackson, do you want to come do the outro with me? Can you say bye?
Papa.
Wave bye.
Papa.
Say see ya.
Yeah.
See ya. But thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe down below. Leave us any comments or questions you might have, because we love hearing from you. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.